As you are aware that Government of India has extended an invitation to the Pakistan Premier Nawaz Sharif, to Bangladesh Prime Minister and to the Sri Lankan Prime President also. We are deeply disappointed with this new policy. All these years we have been listening that the Government of India is weak because of the alliance and the pressure they create on the government on foreign policy. But this time the government is very strong. They don't need any alliance partners or support. So why don't we are trying to project that we are a soft nation? It is time we grow up. It is time we take strong steps. We condemn this action taken by the Prime Minister designate and the people who have advised him. We feel this is a wrong advice to him. Pakistan should not have been invited.
You have written to the President.
We have written exactly the same thing. As an Indian, we are deeply disappointed with the entire outcome. And we condemn this incident completely. We don't want Pakistan Prime Minister to come unless until they change their way, their outlook for India.
What are the allegations?
You said the office side is still there. Dawood Ibrahim is there. It is no secret that Dawood Ibrahim is there. So many news channels have shown us residents in Karachi as well. Some military area or something.
You say Pakistan is engaging in anti-India activities.
It has been doing that all 60 years they have been doing this. It's time we teach them a lesson. It's time we teach us a lesson. We have a stronger government now. We should teach them a lesson. That is our primary
objective.
Definitely. It's a handiwork of Pakistan's IAS. Everyone knows it. You don't need to be very expert in foreign policy to know that.
So Pakistan's Prime Minister coming here, you are saying will be detrimental to India's cause?
Definitely. We don't want Pakistan Prime Minister in India at all. At least for this ceremony. We don't want anyone like Pakistan, Bangladesh or Sri Lanka. The people who are oppressing Indians should not be